Fibromyalgia. I can't even say the name of my memories.
I'm 21.
Hi, hello, hi YouTube. I am the Mrs., also known as Foxy, and welcome to a video today that is a little bit different from what we usually do. Nevertheless, I felt like it was an important video to make, and after a year of being on YouTube, I've finally built up the courage to make it, so here we go. Before we start, I just want to point out that I'm not making this video to try and elicit sympathy or to indulge in some kind of self-centered preening activity. I'm making this video because I want to draw attention to a daily reality so that people who are experiencing the same thing can maybe feel that they are not alone, and those who don't go through it can maybe understand a little bit more about the lives of people who do. So, without further ado, here it is. I have a chronic health condition. I live with fibromyalgia. So what is fibromyalgia? Fibromyalgia, also called fibromyalgia syndrome or FMS, is a long-term health condition that causes pain all over the body. It can also cause extreme fatigue, muscle stiffness, difficulty sleeping, and problems with mental processes such as memory and cognition, which is also known as fibrofrog. It's not yet known what causes fibromyalgia, but it's thought to be related to abnormal levels of certain chemicals in the brain and changes in the way the central nervous system processes pain messages carried around the body. Anybody can get fibromyalgia, though it is more common in women than in men. People generally develop the syndrome between the age of 30 and 50, though it can also occur in elderly people and even children. So, what does this all mean on a day-to-day basis? I was diagnosed with fibromyalgia 5 years ago at the age of 18. And at that age, I was like most of the teenagers. I was planning to go to university, to start living independently from my parents, and generally just wanting to have a good time. Getting fibromyalgia certainly altered these plans. At that point, I was pretty ill, and most days I could barely move out of bed. Sometimes I couldn't even use my limbs, and often I had to use a wheelchair or walking sticks to get around. I had to rely on my parents and Sergeant Wolf a lot to help me to do simple day-to-day tasks like making food, helping me to bathe, and even helping me go to the toilet, which is not something that most 18-year-olds want their parents to be helping doing. I also had to get used to the daily reality that every day I was in pain. So why am I making this video? Well, there's a number of reasons. The first being that I don't want this video to focus on everything that is horrible and bad about living with fibromyalgia. The second is that September the 3rd to September the 10th is Fibromyalgia Awareness Week in the UK. As a young person living with the condition, generally most of the other sufferers I've met over the course of the last 5 years have been a lot older. So part of me wanted to make this video to raise awareness about the condition, as well as the reality of being a teenager and growing with this condition at a very key stage in life. Most of the time, to other people on the outside, I can look reasonably well. The only things that might indicate that I have health problems are the fact that I wear this orthotic on my foot and that I also walk with a stick. I mean, come on, it's rather sexy, isn't it? Come at me. But when most people ask about the fact that I walk with a stick or an orthotic, they make the assumption that I have suffered some form of injury during sports. A lot of people find it difficult to accept that teenagers and young adults can get sick. Most of the time when I explain to people why I walk with a stick, they get uncomfortable and generally make an excuse to get out of the conversation. Or when I'm in my wheelchair, it's often assumed that I can't think or speak for myself. And there have been occasions when people have addressed a question about me to my parents or my fiancé. So that's one reason I decided to make this video. In society today, a lot of people live with diverse and debilitating health conditions, but assumptions on their physical and mental capacities and capabilities or the stories of their health struggles are not okay. Part of the reason that these assumptions are so rife is that we often get embarrassed when talking about health issues, about the messy dysfunctions of our body. To really combat this, we need a more open and honest dialogue about the changes and struggles we all experience with our health on a daily basis. This leads on in a way to the second reason I'm making this video. Another one of these damaging assumptions is that people with chronic health conditions and disabilities are useless. There's a stereotyped image that we just sit at home all day watching daytime television or something of the sort. There's also the danger that people's identities can become reduced to their health condition or disability. This has to stop. Yes, I have fibromyalgia, among other health conditions, but I am not useless and I am not my health condition. I am so much more than that. I am a graduate in French and German and I'm soon going to be starting a master's. I love baking and have created everything from unicorn cakes to cactus cookies. I play wheelchair basketball, I play drums and baritone ukulele. I'm an avid reader, gamer and a YouTuber, and I am also a daughter, a friend and a fiancé. It's fair to say that being diagnosed with fibromyalgia and living with the daily reality certainly changed my life. But it didn't always change my life for the worst. As a person, it made me more resilient, more tenacious and widened my horizons. I don't define myself through my health condition, but I would not be the person I am today without fibromyalgia and the struggles that I've had to come through. And yes, I am proud to say that. I suffer from fibromyalgia, but I am so much more than my fibromyalgia.